पेज नंबर 19.26 कम टू पेज नंबर 19.26 प्रॉब्लम नंबर 17 वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम A, B and C were partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:3:2 respectively. On 31st March 2000, their balance sheet stood as follows. A's capital, B's capital and C's capital balances given below. Creditors, plant and machinery, furniture and fittings, stock, debtors, cash and bank. On 31st July 2000, A died. And according to the partnership deed, on the death of a partner, the capital account of the deceased partner was to be credited with his share of profit for the relevant part of the year of death, calculated on the basis of profit earned during the immediately preceding accounting period. To understand the first point carefully, his share of profit for the relevant part of the year, if the death happens during a year, so during the year, whatever profits have been earned up to the date of death, he has to be given a share. But how to calculate that share in profits? On the basis of profit earned during the immediately preceding accounting period. So you have to find out what is the profit earned in the immediately preceding accounting period. During the same period, what is the profit earned and his share of profit? And his share of goodwill. Goodwill was to be valued at 2 years' purchase of average profits of immediately preceding 3 accounting years. So goodwill is valued at 2 years' purchase of average profits of immediately preceding 3 accounting years. The profits as per books of accounts were as follows. For accounting year ended on 31st March 1998, 3,29,000. For the accounting year ended on 31st March 1999, 3,46,000. For accounting year ended on 31st March 2000, 3,78,000. However, while going through the books of accounts on A's death, it came to light that rupees 30,000 worth of wages were spent on installation of a new machine, but the same was not capitalized. The machinery was put into operation on 1st October 1999. And depreciation was provided on machinery at the rate of 20% per annum. So on 1st October 1999, some additions were spent on a machinery, 30,000. What happened was, instead of adding it to machinery account, we have by mistake debited it to the It came to light that 30,000 worth of wages were spent on installation of a new machine, but the same was not capitalized. So we have paid some wages for installation of a new machine. Wages for installation of a new machine should be added to the cost of the asset, but it was wrongly debited to the profit and loss account. Because of it, two things will happen. One, the profit will be understated. Second, asset is understated. If asset is understated, depreciation is also understated. So now what we have to do? We have to increase the asset, increase the profit, then depreciate the asset. And then reduce the profit. We have to do two things. On 1st October 2000, A's son D was admitted into partnership with immediate effect on the following terms. So on 1st October 2000, A's son D was admitted into partnership. But there is a gap. On which day A died? A died on 31st July 2000. On which date is Mr. D being admitted into the firm? Only on 1st October, that means August, September, 2 months are, we can say, have expired before D was admitted into the firm. A, D would get 1/4 share in the profits of the firm, while the relative profit sharing ratio between B and C would remain unchanged. D would get 1/4 share in the profit of the firm, while relative profit sharing ratio between B and C would remain unchanged. An adjustment would be made in the capital accounts of for account for D share of goodwill. The basis of valuation on firm's goodwill would be the same as at the time of the death of his father. So goodwill valuation at the time of death of Mr. A and the time of admission of Mr. D would be one and the same. On 31st March 2001, the profit and loss account of the firm showed that the firm had earned a profit of 4,16,000 for the year. So at the end of the year, we have found that the firm has actually earned 4,16,000. The respective drawings account showed that while B and C had withdrawn 60,000 each during the year, these drawings totaled to 30,000. The drawings accounts are closed at the end of the year by transfer to respective capital accounts. Your required to prepare statement showing distribution of profits for the accounting year ended on 31st March 2001. Past journal entries for all transactions related to death of the partner and dissolution partnership and at the end of the year related transfer of drawings accounts and distribution of profit for the year. We'll prepare accounts. Okay. Let us start. I think there is no revaluation here. Even if there is any revaluation, we'll directly do through the capital accounts of the partners. Profit and loss appropriation account. Three parts. 1st April 2002, 31st July 2000, 1st August 2002, 30th September 2000, P&L appropriation account, 1st October 2002, 31st March 2001. I have prepared the P&L appropriation account in three parts. This is the profit for the current year, for the year which is going to end on 31st March 2001. Okay. This is 4M. This is 2M. This is 6M. 4 months, 2 months, and 6 months. Next. Similarly, partner's capital account will also be drawn in three parts. Partner's capital account A, B, C and D. Always start with opening balances brought down. Tell me, what is the opening balance of A capital account?
7,79,000.
B capital account?
7,79,000.
C capital account?
6,86,200.
we have one error to be rectified first, let us rectify, but that is not current year error, previous year error. While going through the books of accounts of Mr. A, books of account on A's death, it came to light that 30,000 worth of wages which were spent on installation of a new machinery, but the same was not capitalized. The machinery was put into operation on 1st October 1999. Depreciation was provided on machinery at the rate of 20% per annum. Now, mistake we did was wages paid for installation of machine, instead of debiting it to machinery account, we have debited it to the profit and loss account. That is a mistake we have done. Yes? If we rectify our mistake, what will happen? Machinery will increase by 30,000. If machinery increases by 30,000, automatically profits will also increase by 30,000. But if machinery was properly debited with wages on installation, some depreciation would also have been charged, no? At the rate of 20% per annum for 6 months, because machinery was installed on which date? 1st October 1999. So up to 31st March 2000, how much depreciation would be charged? Press calculated 30,000 into 20% into 6 by 12, 3,000. Profit will increase by 30,000, profit will reduce by 3,000. Or we can say, we have to bring a machinery into the books with a written down value of 27,000. With a written down value of what? 27,000. When you bring a machinery into books, what is entry you pass? Machinery account at R2 revaluation account. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Machinery account or to revaluation account will not create revaluation account, will directly credit the partner's capital account. By machinery, 27,000 in the ratio of 5:2? How much will it be? 13,500. Let us read the problem. On 31st July 2000, A died. According to the partnership deed, on the death of the partner, the capital account of the deceased partner was to be credited with his share of profit for the relevant part of the year of death, calculated on the basis of profit earned during the immediately preceding accounting period, and also his share of goodwill. Now start working notes. Working note number 1. Calculation of correct profits for the year 2000, first of all. Calculation of correct profits for the year 2000, you have to calculate first. Particulars, rupees. Particulars, rupees. Write down. Profits before correction, 3,78,000. 3,78,000. 3,78,000. Below that you write, add wages wrongly debited to P&L account. Add wages wrongly debited to P&L account. 30,000 wages wrongly debited to P&L account, 30,000 less depreciation which has escaped. Some depreciation escaped, no? 3,000. Depreciation which has escaped, 3,000. So what is the balance you get?
4,05,000.
4,05,000. This is the corrected profits for 2000. Okay. Now write down. Deceased partners share in profit. Deceased partners. Deceased means person who has died. D-E-C-E-A. It's not D-I-S-E-A-S-E. Deceased partners share in profit. See, boss, he was alive from 1st April 2002 31st July 2000. So for those 4 months, we have to give him share in profits. But for those 4 months, we are not going to give him share in the actual profits. Actual profits for that year. We are not going to find out what was the actual profits for those 4 months. What is the actual share of the partner who has died? The agreement provides, take the last year's profit, find out what is 4 months profit. In that you give the share of the partner who has died. Okay, write down. It will be 4,05,000 into 4/12. Why 4/12?
4 months.
4 months profits I want to find. Which 4 months profit? The period for which he was alive. But how am I calculating the profit? Last year's profit. Based on last year's profit. I am not taking the actual profits of the current year. 4,05,000 into 4/12 into 5/10. 67,500. Listen to me. Actually, we are going to pass an entry. P&L suspense account debtor to Ace Capital account. By P&L suspense account debtor to Ace Capital. 67,500. P&L suspense account debtor to Ace Capital. Boss, I am passing this entry on 31st July 2000. On that date, my P&L provision account is not open. These accounts are opened at the end of the year. So without having P&L account, how can I write an entry? So use the help of an account, P&L, suspense account, debtor to Ace Capital account. At the end of the year, when we are actually sharing profits, P&L suspense will be closed by debiting it to the P&L appropriation account. Is it clear? So now I debit P&L suspense account here to P&L suspense. This will be passed on 31st July, but this will be passed at the end of the year. Now, what was the total profit earned actually for the year in 31st March 2001? That is 1 year from 1st April 2000 to 31st March 2001. What is profit earned? 4 lakh? Share it in time basis, 4 months, 2 months and 6 months. Tell me how much is it? By profits. 4,16,000 into 4/12 by profits into 2/12 by profits. Retirement and death accounting is same. There is no change. Revaluation of assets and liabilities, valuation of goodwill, treatment of goodwill, sharing of accumulated profits or reserve, joint life policy, preparation of capital account of the partners, and settling their account. If the partner has retired during the year, he will get share in profit for the period for which he was alive. If his account is not settled, section 37 will be applied. Once his account is settled, he will not get anything from the firm. Same. Now we'll continue with sharing of profits later. The first requirement was credit the capital account of the partner who has died with his share in profits for those 4 months, which has to be carried based on last year's profit, which you have done. Okay. Second was the share of goodwill. Now let us raise goodwill in old profit sharing ratio between ABC. What is entry pass? Goodwill account at R2, A capital, B capital and C capital. Write down first working note. Valuation of goodwill. Value of goodwill is not given to you directly in the problem. You have to calculate it. Value of goodwill. Good, right. Read that paragraph. Goodwill is valued at 2 years purchase of average profits of immediately preceding 3 accounting years. Write down. Profits of 2000. Sorry. Profits for the year 98, 329,000. Add profits for 99, 346,000. Add corrected profits for 2000, 405,000. Profit for the year 98, 398,000, 329,000. Profits for the year 98, 329,000. Profits for the year 99, 346,000. And profits for the year 2000, 378,000. 405,000, sir. 405,000. Total. Total 405,000 you will write, not 378. Corrected profit you have to take.
10,80,000
is sum of the profits. Now you write average. 10,80,000 divided by 3. 3,60,000. Average. 3,60,000. Goodwill. 2 years purchase, 360,000 into 2, 720,000. Is the value of goodwill. Now is an entry. Goodwill account at R 720,000 to goodwill account at R 720,000 to A capital, B capital and C capital. (5:3:2) ratio. We are not going to do any write-off now because D's capital account has to be adjusted for his share of goodwill. We are not going to do any adjustment right now. Buy goodwill. 3,60,000. 3,60,000. Now listen to me. Let us close the first part of the appropriation account and first part of the capital account of the partners. Before we do that, are there any drawings of the partners?
Yes, sir.
A has not drawn anything. B and C have drawn 60,000 rupees. Don't debit 60,000 and 60,000. Be careful. Two drawings. Nil. 60,000 by 12 into 4. 20,000. It is 60,000 for the year. 60,000 into 4 by 12. 60,000 into 4 by 12. 60,000 into 4 by 12 and 60,000 into 4 by 12. Now let us close this P&L appropriation account first part. Now We have given A share to him. The remaining part will belong to only B and C now. To B's capital account, to C's capital account. 138,667 minus 67,500. Tell me how much is left, sir? 71,667. Share it among B and C. 3:2 ratio. 42,700. Sir, how did you decide 5:3:2? C. 5:3:2. A died. Over. God will take his share now. Or his son. Later on. 42,000. C share.
28,467.
By P&L appropriation. Nil. 42,700. 28,467 and nil. Why do you want to increase your burden? And I told you yesterday also this point. And I teach you, don't listen to me. Section 37 application I told you. If you do write off, the property of only the partner who has died will appear more in the form. And because of which you'll get more share in profits. Whereas other partners would be losing. Goodwill is not only his property, boss. Goodwill belongs to everyone. So you have to find out the total property of the firm on the date of death. It should include the entire goodwill. 42,700, 28,467. The point which I stress a lot. He will again ask the same point. So, 42,700, 28,467. Okay, that's it. First part is over. Now calculate the balances left. Now my question is, was A's capital account settled immediately? Was he issued a check and sent home? Was the check sent to home? No, boss. The firm has carried on the business without arriving at any settlement with the legal heirs of Mr. A. Section 37 will automatically wake up. Okay. Carry it down. Tell me how much is A's capital account balance?
12,20,000.
12,20,000. B?
9,54,600.
54,600. C?
9,44,067.
D nil. Brought down. Now Monif will ask me, sir, you said P&L appropriation account is going to be prepared at the end of the year, but you have actually shared the profits now itself. Again, for the purpose of application of section 37, I want to know the correct profits of the firm, correct property of the firm on that day. Profits may be shared at the end of the year. Entries may be passed at the end of the year, boss, but property exists on that particular day. Is it correct?
$69,333
is the next 2 months' profits. How to share this? Now there is some suspense. A's account has not been settled. B and C are carrying on business without settlement. Now A will demand profits as per section 37, which says calculate profit attributable to his share in property of the firm or 6% interest, whichever is more beneficial to the partner. Okay. To his legal heir. Okay, write down.
Working not. Write down calculation of A's share in profit. For 2 months. For 2 months. A share in profits for 2 months when business was carried on without settlement. Without settlement. You'll write. Rule 1. Profit attributable to his share in property of the firm. Rule 1. Profit attributable to his share in property of the firm. How to apply the rule? Please tell me what is the total property of the firm. Look at the board, everyone. This is the total property of the firm. Total property of the firm is this plus this plus this. On that we have earned a profit of how much? 69,333. I want to know how much is the profit attributable to share of Mr. A. Write on. Total profit for 2 months, 69,333. Total profits for 2 months, 69,333. Total property of the firm. 12,20,000 plus 954,600 plus 844,067. Total property of the firm, not profits. Total property of the firm, 12,20,000 plus 954,600 plus 844,067. Total property of the firm. 30,80,667. Now I'll write profit attributable to C's property. Not C's property, A's property. Profit attributable to A's property. You'll do it like this. 69,333 into 12,20,000 divided by what was the total property of the firm? 80,667. This is based on the logic. 30,80,667 gives you a profit of 69,333. 12,20,000 will yield how much profit? 28,021 rupees. P&L appropriation account at R to A's capital. 28,021. Wait. I'm sorry. Rule 2. Calculate rule 2 also. Rule 2. 6% interest for 2 months on his property. 6% interest for 2 months on his property. 12,20,000 into 6% into 2/12. 12,200. So which rule is better? You write below that capital as WEB. What is WEB? Whichever is beneficial. WEB, whichever is beneficial. In income tax, you always learn with WEL. Whichever is lower, whichever is lower, whichever is lower. Now, look at the board. 69, 333 minus 28, 2 over, how much is left? I'll write section 37. Now yesterday, a very interesting question was asked by Mr. Vivek to me. He asked me a question. Sir, is that 6% fixed? Can partners change it? Now, I would like you all people to answer by reading this paragraph, page number 19.22, unsettled accounts of a deceased partner. Read that paragraph and tell me, can partners by agreement provide for a higher rate of interest? As per provisions of section 37 of the Indian Partnership Act, where any member of a firm has died or otherwise ceased to be a partner, otherwise ceased, that means stop being a partner, that means retirement is also called, and the surviving or continuing partners carry on the business of the firm with the property of the firm without any final settlement of accounts as between them and the outgoing partner or his estate, then in the absence of a contract to the contrary, underline that sentence, in the absence of contract to the contrary, the outgoing partner or his estate is entitled to option of himself or his representative to such share of profits made since he ceased to be a partner or as may be attributable to the use of his share of property of the firm or to interest at the rate of 6% per annum on the amount of his share of property of the firm. What is the importance of that sentence? In the absence of contract to contrary, that means by contract, different terms can be agreed between the partners. If different terms have not been agreed, in such case this paragraph will apply. So, Vivek, you have your answer now. So, by contract, if you want, you can provide 12% interest also. The partners can provide that if a partner dies and if business is carried on without settlement, then what should be the terms for sharing profits for that period in which the business has, the accounts have not been settled? How much interest will you pay? How sharing profits will be calculated? It can be provided separately by an agreement also. So when there is no contract, this section has to be applied. Is it clear? In this problem, there was no mention of any contract between A, B, C, D. So we have been guided by section 37. Somebody asked me, who is next? So next was Vivek. 69,333 minus 28,021. How much is left?
41,312.
Share it to B's capital account and C's capital account. 3:2 ratio.
21,785.
Whatever you say, like. That is what I told you, no, whatever you say, I'll write. Properly share it and tell me. 16,585. Shravan is, I think, angry on me that every day I am saying he is sleeping in the classroom. Shravan?
I know what I am doing, sir.
Very good. So he is confirming that he is really very angry. Let's continue. Profits 2,08,000. So, I am left with only the last 6 months adjustment. Drawings, okay. Very good. Drawings. How much? 10,000. 10,000. Carry it down. How much is the balance there? Tell me. 12 lakh. The 20. 12,48,021. And balance with.
Nine lakh sixty-nine thousand five ninety-two.
Very good. Wait, don't be in a hurry. This problem came in the exam. This problem is there in ICAI textbook and practice manual also. Before you go to exam hall, this is one problem which you definitely do and go to the exam hall. Remaining all problems are very good. It's also an easy problem. It's just lengthy and little bit confusing because lot of calculations have to be done. Number of holes are more for a student to fall down. Ready everyone? Now enter the dragon. D is now going to enter. D would get 1/4 share in profits, while the relative profit sharing ratio between B and C would remain unchanged. What does that mean? D will get 1/4. Whatever is left will be shared by B and C in their old profit sharing ratio, that is 3:2. So they will say D, you take 1/4. Remaining, both of us will share in the ratio of old profit sharing ratio 3:2. The final balance of A's capital account would be credited to D's capital account. So it is gift from father to his son. The capital account balance is now going to transfer to D's capital account. So this will be brought down here. B and C 969 387 C 850 592 A nil. The father has donated all his belongings to now the son. Would be made in the capital account for D's share of goodwill. The basis of valuation of found goodwill would be the same as was adopted at the time of the death of his father. Same 6 lakh. If you see the entries, we passed an entry, goodwill account returned to ABC Capital. Goodwill account is still waiting for a redemption. Now it has to be written off. What is entry pass when you write off goodwill now? B Capital, C Capital, D Capital account returned to goodwill. So write off now. To goodwill. Wait. Don't be in a hurry. 720 into, even 720 no goodwill, into 1/4 debit to D share. 720 into 1/4. 1,80,000. How much is left now? 5,40,000. It should be shared among B and C in 3:2 ratio. Remaining 5,40,000 should be shared between B and C in 3:2 ratio. D will get 1/4 share, boss. Remaining amount will share equal in their mutual profit sharing ratio 3:2. How much then, please tell me?
3,40,000.
So if you want to prepare a chart. 7,20,000 goodwill, D's share, 7,20,000 into 1 by 4, 1,80,000. B and C share 5,40,000. B 3:2, C 3,24,000, 2,60,000. Note down this chart. What if you do is, you say, Namaste to that problem and not solve that problem in the exam hall. You won't find time. Akash will do only that problem and come back. You sometimes not put your ego in the exam paper. You should not put your ego in the exam paper sometimes. It's going to cause lot of damage to you only. What? Normally that happens sometimes. Student know if he has prepared very well for the exam and a question is asked. Last exam same thing happened. Many people put their egos in the exam paper. I know that. Because non-profit organization, like, it's a basti ka sawal. Because it is like from childhood you have been learning non-profit organization. I have to get this somehow in the exam hall. So they start the problem 1.5 hour over, unable to find the answer, the many paper spoiled. That's it. I also did the same thing in my exam. Higher purchase, I practiced so many times that given any problem I could solve. Question came in the exam. So you cannot solve yourself. You start solving neatly, writing all working notes with all detailed working notes. By the time you see your watch, it's 1 hour over. And then you start running and you fall down. You have to be careful in the exam hall. Ready everyone? Now last 6 months profits. Who are the three partners now? B, C and D. To B capital, to C capital, to D capital. I'll write ulta. Because D is going to get first. 2 D's capital. 1/4 of 2,08,000. How much is it? Balance how much is it? 1,56,000. To B's capital, to C's capital, 3:2 ratio. 92,600. By P&L appropriation, A, goodbye now to A, B, 93,600, C, 62,400, D, 52,000. One more adjustment is left. Drawings. Two drawings, 30, 30, and 30. Balance.
Page number 19.22.